It's almost 1 a.m.
We've been here before. Carry that tune.
I can't. I think I can.
We are at the trailhead, the foot of the Wind River Mountains, Elkhart Park. We're about to embark on a really neat adventure.
The goal is to get a full 90 plus miles and to be the first people to ever summit Gannett twice in a day in a 24-hour period from two separate trailheads. But, you know, we don't know what we're getting into. We know that there's a lot of snow. We've heard it's compact and is very easy to travel over, but it will slow us down. So we'll take what we can get from this trip. We know we'll get at the minimum one Gannett, probably two. Anyway, we'll see in a few hours because we got to be up at 4:15. So we're only going to get about 3 hours of sleep, a proper ultra sleep the night before, and we'll get after it.
Let's do this. So we're heading out Pole Creek Trail from Elkhart Park, and we're overburdened with food. We're 6 miles in. You can see kind of where we're going. That's Titcomb Basin way back up there. We've heard trail conditions are really poor, so we'll figure it out as we go, but this is one of the most beautiful places I've ever been in my life. So far, it's, I would say conditions are slightly less than ideal. Not bad. Probably not ideal. We have just walked up to Seneca Lake.
Wow.
Seneca Lake, and it is stunning.
Wow.
This is crazy. Constantly in water, constantly in snow. Maybe this wasn't the best time of year. Who cares? That was simple. This is officially Titcomb Basin. Unbelievable. What was that?
Skidding. hot on this snow.
Snow is hot.
You're hot.
I'm hot.
July 14th, 2017. Winter's still holding on up here in the Wind Rivers.
Mile an hour.
We get these short breaks where we get to walk on dry ground.
Very short.
Very short. But oh, so lovely. So, so lovely.
Storm's coming in. We just heard some thunder. We're gonna hang out here for a little bit. See if it moves through.
To the side.
We got a boulder over here with a shelf over, like a roof that we can get under. But moving so slow because of the snow. So we'll just do what we can. We're having fun. Scenery's incredible.
You're having fun.
Company is awesome from his perspective.
Truly.
It's awesome.
True.
From my perspective, it's okay.
50-50. It's okay. The amount of effort to just travel on this is insane. And now we gotta go up Bonnie Pass, down, up. We're only 17 miles in. Crazy. All right, as you heard Scott mention, we had to wait out a potential storm, and so we kind of got bundled up a little bit, and we took a nap. We snuggled on a rock, and that's not me being silly. We kind of like legit snuggled for an hour. We feel awesome, and we're ready to go climb Bonnie Pass. We're finally into ice axes and crampons. From here on out, let's just be super careful.
Going up to Bonnie Pass, it's like 12:06. Mixing some Hammer Perpetuum with glacier water.
Delicious.
So good. This stuff is money.
So we're at 12,800 feet. We just came up over Bonnie Pass. It was a brutal climb. The snow is so soft. You just sink in and like kicking steps the whole way, and my feet are absolutely frozen. But we're up here, and Gannett's looking prime. So it's going to be, I'm psyched to go after it and knock this thing out, but still got a lot of work to do. A lot of work to do. Jump the crevasse.
Oh, yeah.
Heading up Gannett. This place is awesome.
We seriously can't win. Now it's raining. Now it's raining. The final push to the summit. Hopefully it'll stop and pass over real quick. We don't have any thunder and lightning, so we're okay to keep moving, but we got to be super careful with if it starts raining harder or if it does start to get really dodgy. Just we can't be exposed on that ridge. But look at this place. Look at this place. It's insane.
We
We made it to the top of the rock pile. Heading towards the Bergstrom. This is the last real obstacle we have, and then we hit the ridge all the way to the summit. Got the summit ridge right there. I'm struggling. Just to be honest, dead honest. Struggling emotionally just to like, I just want to summit and I just want to get off this thing safe.
On the summit of Gannett.
13,000 what? 804?
That was one tough workout. We beat ourselves up. That ridge was gnarly.
I may be having a complete meltdown. I got it together. We're gonna get off this thing. Nice and safe.
Dawned. But look at the Wind Rivers. Tower Peeps. There is no place like this in this country.
So I successfully made it down the big down climb. You can barely see Scott up there. And I'm over the Bergstrom. See, way down into the crevasse there. And that was kind of, for me, the last kind of big nerve-wracking thing. I just, you know, Scott, he's gonna take care of business, and he's gonna go slow and do what he needs to do. Coming over the snow bridge, we were lucky to have a snow bridge, but coming over the snow bridge, I was, you know, you're climbing down backwards like a ladder, and I kicked my foot down, and there's no step, and I looked down, and I kicked through. The Bergstrom opens up on the other side there too, and I kicked through next to it into just open air. I was like, oh, step to my left, because yikes. But yeah, made it, we're good. Yeah, well done, man.
Thanks.
That was big.
I feel a lot better now.
Yeah, me too. Good job.
Ride it! Ride it! Ride that! Ride it! I'm not sure how much of this you can see, but we now have a final 1,300 vertical foot climb. Up snow, and we're tired. We've been going for 16 hours, and amazingly, we're only like 23 miles in. Bonnie Pass, our last big climb. We just have to make it down the other side, and then it's just kind of a long haul out. That climb was brutal. Scott could not be any less happy about the fact that the trail is still going.
It's going on and on and on.
You know what though, Scott?
And on.
You know what?
What?
I don't see the trailhead. I thought I did. It's never gonna end.
We made it.
We see cars. So,
sometimes you set out to run 94 miles and then you end up walking 44 in the same amount of time. And you only summit the mountain once.
But it was awesome.
It was truly amazing.
Yeah.
There were several naps and a lot of walking on snow and cold feet.
Our feet were wet for 29 hours.
Accurate.
Yeah.
Shout out to Hammer for sending us a whole bunch of yummy treats. And to Katadyn, Be Free. This has been a lifesaver, you know. Right. And ultimate direction, because the fast pack, check it out. Spin, dude. Look at that. Everything we need. Amazing. So that's it, guys. We're done. I mean, it only took like 32 hours.
31.4. No, 31 hours and 40 minutes.
Ouch. That is, in duration, my longest ultra ever. But I've run farther in less. Anyway, have a great week. We're done.
That's a diesel.